velocity of transverse wave on a string . Suppose we have a stretched string under a tension of T and with the mass per unit length mu, and suppose a wave is going on this rho. Has a snapshot as shown in this diagram. Now, if we will see this wave moving on this rope, we will see that the entire waveform is moving with a certain velocity. And let us suppose this is called velocity of wave. And in this video, we are interested to find out what will be the velocity of this wave in terms of the parameters tension and mass per unit length. We know that the velocity of transverse wave or the velocity of disturbance passing on this rope will depend on inertial and elastic properties of this rope. Here tension is in a way elastic property and mu is in a way inertial property of the rope. Now suppose we take an element of this rope, AB element, and I will expand this element here because we have this element. Now on the two ends this element is experiencing force tension on each side, and we can take the angles with the horizontal as theta 1 and theta 2. Now this, we know that the elements of this rope will be moving up and down. The elements of this rope will not be moving in the horizontal direction. They will be moving about their mean position as this wave goes forward. So we know that the oscillation of this element will be in downward direction or upward direction. And the mass of this element, we know that it will be, say, mu dx. If I am taking the length as dx, then suppose the oscillation of this element is E, then I know that I can write force on this element will be equal to mass of this element into oscillation. So mass into oscillation, which I can write as mu dx, and oscillation I can write as d2y by dx2. If I am taking the position of this element as x. Now, this let us find out what is the oscillation of this element. Sorry, d2y by dt2. Now, let us find out what is the oscillation of this element in terms of this tension. Now, I am using Newton's laws of motion, and the oscillation of this element is because of these two tension forces only. Now, if I take components of these tension forces, I can write T cos theta 1, T sin theta 1, here T cos theta 2 and T sin theta 2. Now since angles are very small, cos theta 1 will be approximately equal to cos theta 2 will be approximately equal to 1. See, if these are not exactly equal, even then if angle is small, cos theta 1, cos theta 2 can be approximated as 1. This is because 0.99 can be approximated as 0.98 as 1. However, sin theta 1 and sin theta 2, if angles are small, they cannot be taken as 0. They can only be approximated as their angle values or tangent values of these angles. So I can approximate sin theta 1 to be approximately equal to theta 1 or approximately equal to tan theta 1, but I cannot take them to be 0 here. And tan theta 2, I can approximate them to be theta 2 or approximately equal to, sorry, sin theta 2 approximately equal to theta 2 or approximately equal to tan theta 2. So what I am going to do is write the net force on this element, which is now T sin theta 2 minus T sin theta 1 This net force must be equal to mass into acceleration, so mu dx d2y by dt2. Now I can take tension common, and instead of sin, I am going to use tan. So tan theta 2 minus tan theta 1 is equal to mu dx d2y by dt2. Now the reason I am going on this direction is, just to take an overview is that, we know that the general differential equation of a wave in any medium is given as d2y by dx2 is equal to 1 by v square d2y by dt2, and this is general differential equation of wave motion which we have, which we know from general mathematics. So this is the general differential equation of wave motion, and if we can express this disturbance on this rope in this equation, then this term, one over coefficient of this d2y by dt2, will represent the velocity of this disturbance in this medium, which is the rope. So now let us see what tan theta 1 and tan theta 2 represent. Tan theta 1 and tan theta 2 represent slope at x1 and x2. So if suppose this is x1 and this is x2, tan theta 1 and tan theta 2 represent slope at these two points. So I can write this as tension del y by del x at x2 minus del y by del x at x1 is equal to mu dx del 2y by del t2. So this can be written as tension. Now this quantity, this is difference of slope at these two points. I can write this as difference of slope, I can write this as rate of change of slope with x multiplied by dx. See, this is just like how if we want change in velocity, this is equal to acceleration into dt. So here this is just analogous to this thing. So this is difference in slope, like change in velocity v2 minus v1. And this can be written as rate of change of slope, just like acceleration, multiplied by the independent variable, variation in the independent variable. Okay, so this can be written as mu dx del 2y by del t2. Here we remove delta dx. So I get del 2y by del x2 is equal to 1 over t upon mu del 2y by del t2. This implies that velocity of this disturbance in this medium is equal to v square is equal to t by mu. So velocity of this disturbance is root of t by mu, which is the velocity of a disturbance passing in a rope under tension T having mass per unit length mu.